with you. 28 minutes. Yeah, that's 28. Well, I'll tell you, the time is flying by. Happy Thursday to you. Bill Martinez here. 28 minutes before the top of the hour. For more info on the show, BillMartinezShow.com. That's where you want to go. Hey, up next is a good friend of mine. Guy, I've known Jerry Baggett for years through our mutual friend who happens to be my personal doctor. He might even be his personal doctor as well. He might trust him enough to call him his personal doctor. Dr. Figueroa and I go back to grade school together, and he introduced me to Jerry years ago. And I tell you, I keep telling Dick, I said, but Jerry never takes me out in his boat. I don't even think he even knows how to skipper a boat. I think it's just all for show. It's just there. So I'm only giving him a bad time. But Jerry Baggett, you know, I find out not only is he this incredible businessman and yachtsman, he really is a yachtsman. He just doesn't have a boat just for show, by the way, ladies and gentlemen. Truthfully, he is an accomplished yachtsman. But he's also an accomplished author. I mean, you know, this is a thing. It's interesting, you know, how you will know people for so long and you think you know them. And then there's always something else. I mean, it just makes him so mysterious. Jerry, I've never known that you were just, but I think that's part of your charm. You hold back a little bit of mystery just for fun, don't you?
I don't know, Bill. You give away a lot.
Did I give away too much? Well, I didn't tell anybody you were on witness protection, so I didn't tell them that.
Well, thank you for that, anyway. Well, thank you anyway, Bill. Thanks for the interview today.
Well, I'll tell you, I've been looking forward to this. You've blessed me so much because, like I said, you know, it is kind of surprising when you think you know somebody, and then all of a sudden, you find something about them that you didn't know. Like this has never happened to you, right?
Right. Well, you know, you were talking about our mutual friend, mm-hmm. Dick. Well, Dr. Dick, we call him.
Yeah, yes, right.
Yeah, and, you know, he bought a boat, a big boat. He thought it was like driving a car. You just get in the yacht, a 45-foot yacht, and take off. Well, he asked me if I would give him a few lessons on handling that thing. Mm. First day out, I thought he was going to wreck the marina getting out of the slip. But anyway, he's a good friend and yes. Turned into a great boater.
Yes, well, good for him. He's another one. He didn't take me out in his boat either. I don't know what it is, but, you know, and I love to go out there on the water, having grown up. You know, I mean, I grew up right around the corner from where you live. And so the ocean was a big part of my life. And I've always, whenever I've gotten a boat, I know enough to, you know, crew because I'll follow orders. But to take a boat out by myself, yes, I think the marinas would be wincing and fearful if they saw me skippering a boat. So I'm trying to keep the marinas safe. But anyway, good fun, you know, to be talking to you here, Jerry, especially about this book in the blink of an eye. Like I said, what a pleasant surprise. And like I told you, I just was so impressed with your writing. I mean, this is, you know, this book, ladies and gentlemen, you get your hands on it. And Jerry just is very gifted. You can tell when an author is really special and they have a gift of writing. I mean, how you tell a story and pull all the parts together, it's really, you know, nothing short of wonderful.
Well, thank you, Bill. You know, it's a lot of work to write, but it's a lot of pleasure as well.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Writers, you know, spend years writing a book and then spend a great deal of disappointment trying to publish.
Mm-hmm.
And that's unfortunate because it's so much work does go into a good book.
Exactly. Now, this is what number book is this for you that you've written?
Well, that's number four.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I published three books prior to that, and I have another new book that's going to be published next year, be released mm-hmm. next year. But I also have a republication of my three earlier books.
Mm-hmm.
The publisher wants to republish those under a new name for mm-hmm. international distribution.
Right.
So, and I'm looking forward to that. I, I, I want to try to let a lot of my readers know that the story of Dammit, the original story of Dammit, will be republished.
I see. Yeah, Dammit is an interesting character. In fact, when I first read that, I thought, was this a publisher error?
No, you know, Dammit.
Yes, right.
You know, my son says he's Dammit because, you know, my wife is a fun-loving gal was in her younger days. And,
yes.
And, you know, my son was in a lot of mischief, so every time he turned around, she was saying, Dammit, he's into trouble again. And he says he thought his name was Dammit until he started school. Well, of course, that was not true. But
right. But you had to carry that through one of your books. I had a friend, obviously, and you know, it was a hippie person, a hippie friend, and they named their child I'm You. Because it was always, hey, you right? You, yeah, do this, right. You do this. And he said, well, I'm You. So they just said, the heck with it. We'll just name him I'm You.
Yeah, yeah.
So I keep thinking one day he's going to be a rock star. I'm going to see his name on the billboard somewhere with, you know, a unique name like that. But, yeah, so Dammit is one of the characters, your son, you know, reads that and smiles and thinks, Dad's writing about me again.
Yeah, that's right. He does. Mm. You know, today he's the president of a company, but he still talks about it. He says, that was me.
Well, and you can't help but chuckle. And in the book, Dammit is the brother of one of the of your star here. You know that the Navy pilot who goes down. And falls out of the sky like an angel and, meets up with a local nurse that kind of, you know, heals him up a little bit. And they're kind of drawn. There's, a little romantic friction right from the get-go here. Huh?
Yeah, this Aragon fighter pilot, Dick McGowin, drops out of the sky. He leaves his crippled fighter plane off the coast of California's Catalina Island and goes in to sea there, and he's shocked when the most beautiful woman he's ever seen reaches out to pull him out of the sea aboard her little sailboat.
Right.
So the story develops from there, and it takes the reader across the country with like a roller coaster ride, I think.
Yeah. No. How the mystery. I mean, little do you know, you're going to end up in this twisted mystery as you read through it. I mean, for me, being a former Marine and military, and knowing that ditching a plane is no easy thing. I mean, that comes with an incredible amount of responsibility. Right. I mean, here he is. He's about ready to retire, and he's ditching a plane at this point in his career. But fortunately, because of his background, it's manageable. It wasn't his fault. But whenever you set down a plane that's worth that many millions of dollars, you got some explaining to do, right?
That's for sure. So you're going to be in front of a review board for a long time.
Yes.
They're going to turn you every which way but loose.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Exactly. And so, he goes through the process. And meanwhile, the story continues. And Jerry Baggett will tell us more about it on the other side of the break. We've got a quick couple-minute break to get out of the way here. And we're talking about his latest book, In the Blink of an Eye. This is the fourth book. Is it the fourth in a series, Jerry? Is that what this is?
They're not a series, but they are tied in with a lot of the same characters appear in each book.
How much fun is that? Well, we'll talk with Jerry a little bit more, and you'll get a little bit more understanding. And, of course, this is going to entice you all the more to get your hands on his book, In the Blink of an Eye. I'm Bill Martinez. It's just about 18 before the top of the hour.